everybody. Welcome to my channel. Today I'm here with another video. You have been subscribed to me for a while. You know that I don't just do wig reviews and hair reviews. I do all types of videos, informational videos. I review websites and also just give you guys information about different things that have been beneficial for me. So I haven't done one of these kind of videos in a while. This video is going to be about mystery shopping. A few months ago, I did a video about surveys. The whole purpose of doing that video was to help people and to give people an honest opinion about the particular survey site that I use. Another thing that I do and I've been doing for 3 years now is mystery shops. I didn't see a whole lot of videos on YouTube really giving a lot of information about mystery shopping, and I've been doing it for so long that I just felt like I should come out with a video giving you guys full information about mystery shopping. So let's go ahead and get started. One thing that I want to say is you never should have to pay to be a mystery shopper. So if you ever see a website that's telling you to send money or pay, that's not really legitimate. So you definitely kind of want to stay away from that. I've mystery shopped for maybe about 4 or 5 companies, and I've never had to pay a dime to become a mystery shopper. So that's just the first thing that I want to throw out there. And the second thing that I want to say is that a lot of times mystery shopping doesn't have anything to do with shopping. I don't know if it started off being about shopping. At one point in time, it was primarily about shopping, but nowadays it's not. You do not have to have a lot of money and spend a lot of money to be a mystery shopper. The whole shopping part is not really about spending money. It's about shopping the location that you go to see if they are a location that provides great service to customers. So I hope that makes sense. It's not really about spending money. It's about shopping to see if this is a location that provides great customer service to customers and is a location that you would recommend consumers to spend their money at, you know, based off of how they treat customers. There are different types of mystery shops. You can mystery shop any type of business, from a bank to a gas station to a grocery store to a cell phone company. Okay, so let me just give you guys an example. A mystery shop at a cell phone company would involve you going into the cell phone retailer and pretending that you are interested in service and basically seeing how that representative treats you. You will get a guideline of what the particular client is looking for and expecting out of that associate at that location. And you know, you basically make mental notes, make sure that the associate is doing what is required by the client. After you do that, you go ahead and you go home, and then you basically fill out an evaluation form, checking off and, you know, telling what the associate did or did not do. And you know, if you want to provide any extra notes, you do that as well. That's an example of a mystery shop that does not require you to spend any money at all. Now, I will give you an example of a mystery shop that does require you to shop. Let's just say you go to Walgreens and you are supposed to evaluate how you're treated when you walk into the store, and then they have you go to a specific department. They will give you the scenarios. Let's just say they may have you go to the photo department, and you'll just go to the photo department and say, hey, I'm looking to make a photo album. You know, you're gonna evaluate how you're treated by the associate that works there. They'll also be evaluating the cashier when you go to Walgreens. They may say you have to spend $1. So basically you just go get a Snickers bar, go up to the cashier to pay, and just evaluate how she treats you, and just, you know, you compare that to the guidelines that they're asking for in the evaluation form. And that's it. And then you turn around and you get reimbursed up to a certain amount. So if they say you can spend up to $1 and you'll be reimbursed for the dollar that you spent. You paid the amount of money that you're supposed to get paid to complete the mystery shop. Okay, so that's an example of a mystery shop where you do spend money. Other examples of mystery shops where you spend money but you get reimbursed are mystery shops at fast food restaurants, mystery shops at regular restaurants, and also mystery shops at maybe grocery stores and maybe clothing stores, even home improvement stores. So that's really all a mystery shop is. You may spend 10 minutes of your time and you may make between $10 to $250, you know. So it's totally depends on what type of mystery shop you do. You're not gonna get paid buku bucks just to do something so simple. That's just not how it works. But if you do a lot of mystery shop in one area in a short period of time, it really does add up to be pretty good money. I may do mystery shops over a weekend, so maybe a Friday and a Saturday, and I may make $200 between Friday and Saturday from doing maybe 5 to 8 mystery shops, okay? And I probably spent a few hours, maybe about 4 hours doing that. So $200 in 4 hours may not be a lot of money to you, but it's a lot of money to me. And if you count how much time you sit around on Facebook, on Snapchat, just messing around, and you could have been making money, that's just a whole different way to look at it. Now that we've cleared up what's mystery shopping and, you know, all of that, I'm gonna go ahead and tell you guys how I'm able to make hundreds of dollars a month mystery shopping, okay? And the way that I do that is between the two mystery shopping companies that I work with, I sign myself up for several mystery shops in one area. And I'm willing to travel maybe between 20 and 25 miles at the most to complete mystery shops. The way that you get the most bang for your buck is you sign up for several mystery shops in that same area. You know, you take all of the different types of mystery shops. It can be gas station mystery shops, bank mystery shops, pharmacy mystery shops, home improvement mystery shops. If there are 10 of them in an area within a distance of about 15 miles of each other, I go ahead and I sign up for all of those, and I do all of those in the same day. This would have to be on a day where you have time, okay? So I sign up for those all in one day, and I complete all of those in one day. Now, the way that that is beneficial is you're getting the most money for your buck. You're also getting the most money for the amount of gas that you spend. Turn around and use a fuel calculator website, take a route out, and I determine how much money is gonna cost me in gas to travel there and do those mystery shops. Let's just say I'm doing 6 mystery shops and they pay $12 each, okay? That's $72, and let's just say it's costing $9 in gas to get there. 12 times 6 is 72. And I turned around and it took me two hours to do 6 mystery shops. I made $72, I spent $10 in gas, okay? So I made my money back plus a profit, okay? So that's how I do that. If I do that on a Friday and a Saturday every weekend, that adds up to be a few hundred dollars a month. So that's how I make my money mystery shopping. I've been doing that since 2013. I'm gonna name some of the companies that I've worked with, and these are companies that I would recommend and that I haven't had any issues with. The first company is Merit's Research, main company that I use to do mystery shopping. Another company that I've done mystery shopping with is Bestmark. I'm gonna show you an example of some of the different types of mystery shops. Okay guys, here's an example of a gas station mystery shop. And with this particular mystery shop, you have to reveal that you're a mystery shopper, but that's most of the time not the case. But as you see, it does show how much they pay you for this, and it also shows how much of a product purchase you're supposed to have, and also a fuel purchase. And as you see there at the top, it does state that you will be reimbursed for your fuel, your in-store purchase, and your shopper pay. As far as how much money you make, of course that depends on you and how many mystery shops you're willing to do, how much time you have, and how far you're willing to travel. If you do make a certain amount of money, I believe it's either $500 or $600 in a year's time mystery shopping, you will be required to report that income on your taxes and pay taxes on that money. You're literally working, you're considered an independent contractor. The mystery shopping company will send you a 1099 form. Okay, so I think I've covered everything with you guys. I love mystery shopping. One thing that I love about it most is I'm really big on customer service. Today's customer service is definitely on a decline. And it's always nice to go places and actually see companies that treat their customers right. Very passionate about making extra money comfortably and legitimately. And, you know, I have a wealth of information about how to do that. And you don't have to sell anything. You don't have to pay money to do it. You know, no offense to people that sell stuff and, you know, do the body wrap stuff and all of that. That's just not my thing. Like, all the companies that I mentioned in this video, along with a website that gives you all types of different resources on how to make extra money from home and just in general, will be in the description bar as well. If you guys like this video, please give me a thumbs up. If you guys know anybody that's had questions about mystery shopping and is looking for an easy way to make extra money and you think they will be a good fit for mystery shopping, definitely share this video. If you guys have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below. I'll definitely respond. I try to respond to everybody as best as I can. I appreciate you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video.